Hi, signs. It's Jo from Angels and Ancestors, and this is your Law of Attraction reading for March 2022. Darlings, I'm so sorry. I know it's going up a few days late, but I endeavoured to get them up by the 5th and the 6th of March. So hopefully by the end of tomorrow, all four of the elements will be up and ready for you to view. Now, for anybody who's been here before, you know this is not a tarot reading per se, although it will tap into your energies about what it is that you are finding easy and what you're finding difficult about the law of attraction, about manifestation, about cleansing and clearing, gratitude, affirmation, all of those sorts of things. So we always start with an energy card and then I go through all of the cards, and we start off with manifestation, authoring and storytelling, resistance card. Sometimes I do that in that line, sometimes I wait until the end depending on the flow of the reading. And then over here we've got cleansing and clearing, and we've got inspiration and action. Here we've got love and gratitude, and here we've got affirmation and destiny. Down the middle you have got energy, you have got your resistance card, and you've got your happiness within card. So darlings, we're just going to get on with the reading, air signs. And I did bring glasses in with me. I thought I had a very pretty card. Initiate. Curiosity, open and warm. This is your energy. How beautiful is that? Look at that fairy. Isn't she beautiful? I'm kind of getting, no matter your age, you're starting out on something. Perhaps this law of attraction stuff is just new to you. Or you feel that it's new to, I've just heard they feel it's new to them. Darlings, you may have been practicing the law of attraction, but never, like me, I was practicing it for years. Never had the terminology for it. Didn't have the terminology for it until about 2 years ago, 3 years ago. 3 years ago, because it was when I, 3 years ago. So I started to get the terminology for it then, 3 years ago. So, if you are new to law of attraction, no, it is a law, it's a law very similar or same as the law of gravity. It is a law. It works for everybody all the time. And I know people are going to shout at the screen and go, don't work for me. Yes, it does. Yes, it does. It depends on what you're putting out there is what you get back. And if you are constantly putting one thing out there, you're going to constantly get one thing back, whether it's good, bad or indifferent. So darlings, let's get on with your reading. Manifestation, make a wish, manifest, speak or write what you want, ask, believe and receive. And here we have justice. It's an air card, there you go. Number 11. Usually people talk about this being Libra, but there's, you've, to do manifestation, I get that you need justification in what it is that you do. You need your scales to be in balance and you need your sword to be ready to cut out what no longer serves you. In manifestation, darlings, you have got to just ask, believe and receive. I've got the scales there. I do love that thing. But when you're manifesting, don't try and think things through too much. Don't try to have too much of a justification of why you are manifesting. The universe isn't interested in that. They just want to know what you want and what you're working towards, and that you are going to take positive steps to make it happen. It's no good just putting it out there and going, I want a car, and then do nothing to help that process come along. You've got to start looking for cars. You've got to start going onto websites and putting in the different things that you would like in a car. You need to be more proactive. And while your scales are unbalanced because you need a justification for what it is of what you want rather than what you need, your manifestation's going to be a little bit off. So just know that you don't need to be justified. You don't need to answer to anybody else. The only two people that this involves is you and the universe. You are partnering the universe to make this happen for you. I'm don't think there's an awful lot more I can say about that. Just speak or write what you want, and then that brings us to the authoring and the storytelling. Eight of Earth. Darlings, you be your own author. Tell your story as if it's happened. Give it feeling and emotion. You've got the Eight of Earth. Lovelies, I'm getting you're a bit of a master at this. I'm getting that you write things down all the time. You may have some earth within your birth chart, but I am getting that eights for me are about communication. This is about basic communication. This is for me the communication of music. It's the communication that you are the master craftsman. You've done all of the apprenticeships. You've been the craftsman, and now you're moving into this where you're just making really sweet music. Whatever you're doing, writing, making money, having a career, having a family, having a home life, I'm kind of getting that you have been doing this without having the terminology. You know this stuff. So when you are writing, authoring, storytelling, what it is that you want, if you are ready to put it out there verbally, you just put it out there verbally. You just say it out loud what you want. If you want to revisit that, if you want to write it down, my advice is to handwrite it rather than type it, because it's more personal to you. I would have a book where you can write your manifestations in. I would also have slips of paper where you can write your manifestations on and pop them into your pocket or your purse, that you can look at them regularly and repeat themselves to you. I'm getting you've been doing that. You just didn't know that it was the law of attraction. You didn't know that it was manifesting. You just thought, that's what I want, I'm going to write it down, I'm going to keep revisiting it. And you've been doing it. The only thing that's been off with you is this need to justify, and the feeling that you're always in the mode of being the apprentice. You're not. You're the master. You're the master craftsman. You are the master musician. Your storytelling is second to none. When you're telling these stories, you're not telling them as if they are about to happen, or you're telling them literally as the law of attraction tells you to, and that is, it's happened. Your story has happened. And as you're writing, you are literally saying, the guy turned up with my car and he handed me my keys, and now I'm sitting in the seat turning the ignition on. And you're coming up with all these emotions of how that's making you feel. And that's amazing. Let go of the thought that you are an initiate. You're not. You may have the curiosity, you may be warm, you may be open to it, but you are definitely not an initiate. You're not an apprentice anymore. You are the master craftsman of what you do. You've got this down to pat. Apart from that justification, you need to let that go. Just let the justification of what you want go. So I'm going to skip over your resistance just for a minute, because this is so tied in with the next two that's coming up, cleansing and clearing and inspiration. You're cleansing and clearing, darling. You've got the Ten of Pentacles. You are so in tune with yourself, in tune with what it is you do for a living, what it is you do as a person, what it is that you have around you, that you've become really aware of what it is that you need to do to cleanse and clear. You're really aware that you need to clear out the old debris in order to make room for new stuff to come in and grow properly. You may have an issue with letting things go. It's a little treasure chest down there. And I'm not saying let your treasures go. Don't do that. Your treasures are your treasures. And I have to say, spiritual and material do meet. They do meet. They're on the same plane. It's you. You are the higher vibrational energy here, and you understand that spiritually, emotionally, mentally, that you need to release some old debris, old data, in order to let this new growth come in. You're there, you've done it. This is, you're cycling one cycle out and bringing a new cycle in. You've got a beautiful wolf down here as well. Darlings, I have to say, I think that you are doing this beautifully. I do. You've just got a couple of little tweaks to do, and you will find yourself renewing things. And I'm getting that you've tested the waters, that you've kind of cleared the deck a little bit, and you got rid of a little bit of debris, and you asked for something, and it happened, and it came in, and it grew. And I kind of like think that it may have amazed you to the point where you wanted to test it again, but you're not quite sure how to do that. Know that you're the master of this. You've mastered it. It is there. And then once you've done the cleansing and clearing and made way for the new, you're always listening out for inspiration, for those little voices that tell you what it is that you want to do. And when those little ideas drop into your head, make sure that you are writing them down, making a record of them. There's nothing the universe likes more than some positive reaction to what they've just popped into your head. Messenger of fire. Now, the messenger is like the knight of fire. Now, the knights come in with messages. That's why it's in this deck, it's called the messenger. And the knight of fire comes in with the message of passion, desire, projects, plans, and people. So if you have been inspired to start a project, a plan, or follow people, if you have been inspired through passion and desire to get something done because it's been dropped into your lap, and I'm kind of getting that you've been manifesting something around your career or your home life or a combination of those. Darlings, it's happening. Something's been dropped into your lap. It's not just a thought in your head. It is a phone call. Somebody has either found your CV online, or they have heard your name in the circles you move in, and all of a sudden things are moving for you. Those inspirations that you've been writing down, what it is that you've wanted, that success in your career, a little bit or a lot more money in your pocket, I'm getting that that is now part of your inspiration. And because that's now happening, you're going, oh my God, what else can I do? What else? Listen to your inspiration and action it. What is the next step for you? What is your manifestation? What is it you're asking the universe to partner with you next? Your passion, your desire. It may not be your work. It may be that you're deciding, hold on a second, if I can do this and there is such a call for this out there, why can't I go out on my own and do it? So it could be that step by step you are getting each and every of your manifestations, but it's giving it to you in pigeon step style, so that you can get used to the fact that you are doing this. You are manifesting to the point of mastery. That's all I can say. It's to the point of mastery. It is. This is the only bit that lets you down, is that you have to justify to yourself and maybe to the universe why it is you're asking for that, or justify your feelings around that. So it may be that you need to do a little bit more work about how you feel about things, so that you're allowing the new growth, the clearing out and the new growth to come in. That's a really nice reading. Now we're going to go back to your resistance card. What did I do with my glasses? I'm just going to pull that out because that's my lunch cooking. Hold on a second. that's nearly done. Okay. So, your resistance, sorceress. Rituals, power and will. Okay. See, your resistance is you. Your resistance is you, sorceress. Number three. Darlings, stop thinking traditionally. Think out of the box for a change. The power that you have inside is nothing to do with having power over other people. It is your personal power. Your, I don't you call it power. I call it magic. It's your own personal magic. It's that bit inside you that makes you completely individual. And then it says about will. Are you willing? Are you willing to accept that you have got this gift? Because this is another form of magic. And it could be that your resistance is that you are really traditional in what you do. It doesn't matter how you put it out there. Prayer, petition, chanting, manifestation, doesn't matter. Don't then think to yourself that because you're doing this, you're giving away your other rituals or your traditions. You're not. It's okay. The power that you wield is your magic. And let me tell you, it makes your light shine so brightly. It really does. But it's not power over other people. It's not the kind of power that world leaders have over their countries. This is a within power. And you know you've got that. You've got it in spades. Your will, nobody else's. Will you? Won't you? Are you willing? Are you not willing? Darlings, I'm kind of getting that you're getting a bit muddled with some terminology. So if you are actually practicing some form of magic, kind of like either work it in so it works together, because this is very magical, or separate it off completely. But don't sort of do bits and pieces of both and then kind of like, oh, hold on a second. Have I done that right? No. Magic and law of attraction go like this. The same as prayer, petition has got its place. It has. Just, I love this card so much. Keep looking at it. You've got the ivy. You've got berries in there. Your stars and moons and a peacock feather. Darlings, I'm kind of getting that your resistance is, and this is going to be for some people, this isn't going to be for all people. You stand in such a powerful position with what you already know, that sometimes you may feel that this is a backward step magically for you. It isn't. It isn't. Let this walk beside you. Let it walk beside you. There is a place for this in magic. There really, really is. That's really interesting that you've gone from initiate to sorceress. Now I can't wait to get to the bottom one. But that is your you are your own resistance. You are your own worst enemy here. And that comes back to this justification. Can I justify not only what you want, but can I justify this with my other base beliefs? You want to. It's the energy around you. You want to. That's why you're feeling like an initiate, because you're not. You are the sorceress. So, darlings, going on to the next part. I love you. The three most powerful words in the world. Say them often. Start with you and then let the love flow to others. And yes, in your head is fine. Nine of Pentacles is such an earthy reading. You've got the 8, 9 and 10. Nine of Pentacles, darlings. You're almost to a 10 with this one. The I love you. Now look at her. She's wearing a bit of a mask. She's got ritual clothing on. And I'm going to say to you that I think that you are practicing I love you already. You are practicing the art of selling the art of self-affirmation. And I'm getting that the majority of you air signs are absolutely 100% on your way to loving yourself, embracing who you are completely. It may be a work in progress. You may still have trips and hazards that you are looking at. But just remember, those trips and hazards are usually given to us by other people, by society. So when you have those, when you have those wobbles, and you look in the mirror and you're like, well, I'm not pretty enough, or I'm not handsome enough, or I'm not tall enough, or I'm not short enough, or I'm not skinny enough, not fat enough, all of that, because I've heard that recently. I've got a really close friend who is painfully thin, but that's her. She's been that way since she was a kid. She's a very tall lady, and I actually heard somebody say to her that she was miles too thin. What the fuck are you supposed to do? She's like a bleeding horse. Just know that that's society's views. That's what's happened is, instead of society accepting each other for who we are, we have allowed the big corporations to come along and tell us who we are and what we should be. You know, who was the first person that told anybody that they were fat? It wasn't another human being. It was a corporation trying to make money out of slimming products or gym memberships. It's that kind of thing. So just know, with the Nine of Earth, you are well on your way to putting aside what it is that society has tried to pigeonhole you at. And I'm kind of getting the fat, thin, tall, short, dark, blonde, it doesn't matter. You have kind of embraced who you are and gone, do you know what? Stuff the rest of the world. If people don't like it, they don't have to be around me. And then I know air signs, because you will then go, hold on a second, is that really what I want? Is that really what I'm thinking? And you will process it. Try not to process it. Try and be grounded over this. You have got this right. You love yourself. You are affirming yourself. You are respectful of yourself. And you expect that back from other people, and rightly so. Because what you're doing is, by loving yourself, by respecting yourself, and having those boundaries in place, you are sending out high vibrational energy to other people. Because as you learn to love yourself, that light changes. What you're sending out into the universe changes. That smile goes from that nervous, I'm not quite sure smile to I'm absolutely fucking confident smile. Now you're doing this. You are doing this. And do you know something? That high vibrational energy, it screams on this top row. It screams. You're just having a little bit of a hiccup. That's all it is. So, my darlings, yeah, right under justice as well, right under justice. You've got this down. You really have. Stop doubting yourself. Stop muddling up what it is that you are capable of doing, and you know you're capable of doing. And then muddling that up with what you would like to do. Two different things. So if there's something else you would like to do, you're capable of doing it, you just haven't found that you're capable of doing it yet. So, my lovelies, we're going to move on to gratitude. Be thankful for everything, from the smallest thing to the largest blessing. The attitude of gratitude, a great state to be. Six of water. do you know something? I am getting that you are so grateful, but there is something around you. I'm getting that you are practicing gratitude, but there are some things around you that are buried that you still need to work on. I'm kind of thinking that it's more to do with memories than it is with the here and now. I'm kind of getting that you've given so much of yourself, even as a child coming up into your adult years, something very, very precious that as you give it out, you can't then regain that back because it's part of you, it's gone. And I'm kind of getting that you've been on a mending spree. You've been on this kind of like understanding that you need to put yourself back together. There is a simple way. If you've given something to somebody of yourself and you want it back, have a pretend bloody fishing line and a fishing rod and send it out and reel it back in. Get it back. It's symbolic. It's only symbolic that you feel that that bit has gone. You can get it back. This card. There are pearls here. So there's pearls of wisdom. There are lilies and lily pads for healing. Water for healing. And you're sitting on the edge of the water. Kind of like contemplating. Darlings, you're grateful, but what's missing? You're grateful, that's what I just heard. You're grateful, but what's missing? What's making you feel that you need to do more work on you? What is it? Write it down. Get it down into words. See what it is that you're trying to explore. In a normal reading, I would say that a secret, a gem of wisdom, something has been said from the past, and it doesn't tally up with how you remember those events unfolding. Darlings, no two people are going to remember the same thing, but this has made you question your gratefulness for the here and now. Don't do that. Don't do that. Work on the past. Be grateful for the lessons that you've learned, and everything else is debris. Just cleanse and clear it out of the way. You know how to do that. You know to release things. And if you're stuck about releasing something, take a couple. Yeah, I was just saying before the camera really turned off. Take a cup of water outside. Say what it is that you want to release. Pour the water into the ground. Now, if it's concrete, try and find a crack. If it's grass, that's fine. If it's just earth, that's fine. Watch that water disappear into the ground and let it take whatever it is that is bothering you with it. That's a way of cleansing and clearing. It is. There's another way of cleansing and clearing, and it goes with I love you, and the I love you and the gratitude goes together. And it's as simple as I love you. Just keep saying it. I love you, I love you, I love you in your head. It will help you cleanse and clear the space around you. Don't get too caught up in I don't want you to get caught up in the feeling that you have to feel gratitude for past events that have hurt or harmed you. And if they haven't hurt or harmed you, but somebody has come along and said something to you that has made you think that it's different to what you feel it was, go and work on that. What is it that you remember? What is it that's different that they're remembering? You know, was you in a different place to them? Were you on a different side of whatever this event was? Was you an organizer? Was you just a participant? It doesn't matter. Whatever it is that's stirring up, that's making you worried about being grateful for the past, you can only be grateful for your experiences, for your lessons. Don't let other people then come in and drain you energetically around your gratitude. Don't let them do that to you. So lovelies, we're going to move on to affirmation. Be kind to you. So talk about your life and what you want in positive terms. Stop saying but can't, won't. They cancel your dreams and wishes. You've got the Five of Water. Now, the Five of Water is usually a bit of a disaster, but it is all about letting go of things that no longer serve you. It's all about allowing that flow to come around you and understand that what's been left is you. There may be spilt water, there may be spilt milk, but you have still got you. So your affirmation should be that you stand strong in your power with your curiosity and warmness, justified in being the master craftsman and having the ability to do all of this for yourself. You'll have to rewind that because I haven't got a clue what I just said. Five of Water. Be kind to you. You do not have to. The Five of Water is about letting something go. If you're not ready to let it go, write it down. Write it down what it is, who it is, how it is, and then try to understand why you can't let it go and allow the universe to come in and partner with you around working on that until you've got your affirmation in place about you, a positive affirmation that you can feed into. Now, an affirmation doesn't have to be War and Peace. It can be one line, it can be a poem, it can be anything you want. If you can't think of an affirmation for yourself, lovelies, there are hundreds out there on YouTube. There are. Just go and have a look and see which ones you like that you can tap into. Because once you get the idea of it, you will come up with your own. So your destiny, create the one you want. Blessings to look forward to. Eight of Air. Look at this. Messages from heaven. Now that is an angel sending those beautiful white feathers down as messages to your loved ones below. So if you've had somebody that has recently passed, they're trying to get a message to you. They're trying to get a message to you. But your destiny, my darlings, is affirming people's messages. Now, whether you do something like this, whether you're a spiritual medium, a light worker, an earth angel, a crystal child, an indigo child, a rainbow child, whatever it is that you are, know that that is your destiny. It is your destiny to give these messages out to other people. And I am getting for you that you would want these messages passed on. That's why you endeavour to pass them on to other people. I'm also getting that with this particular card, it's like in meditation, in a meditation state or in a dream state, you're able to actually go and serve these messages to people who are asleep or in another meditative state, like a dream type state. You're able to walk through people's dreams. You're able to give that message. It doesn't matter where they are in the world. You've got the ability to Oh, it's not time warp, is it? What is that damn word? Do you know what? It really annoys me because the spirits have been talking to me all the way through this bloody reading and then they shut up because I can't remember a word. Oh, astral travel. That's the one. Thank you. Someone just popped in and said it. You have the ability to astral travel. You have the ability to pass on these messages to people in dreams. You can walk through people's dreams. You have got the ability to do that. So, my darlings, happiness from within. And I'm really looking forward to this. Oh, my God. Look at this. The Sigil Keeper, number 38. Symbols, signs and messages. And the biggest symbol, 38, added together is an 11. It's another 11. Two 11s, 11, 11. Is there any more on there? 14, 3, 6, 9, 8, 10. 11, 11. Oh no, it'd be the page, wouldn't it? No, it's all right. So, no, you've got two. 11, 11. Look at that. If there's nothing else you take from this reading, there's synchronicity going on here. 11, 11. 11 in numerology, prime number or soul number, however you want to explain it. 11s are your teaching and your learning. It is the bottom one. So 11, 22, 33, 44, the higher you get, the closer to the divine you get. The higher you get, the higher your vibrational energy is, the more like your divine you are. With the 11s, you are on that first rung. You are on your way to having those life's lessons to continue on your journey. Darlings, look at this. Initiate, sorcerer, sigil keeper. I swear to God, Libra. I honestly, do you feel like you're always renewing something? Do you feel that sometimes you feel so powerful, so magical that it gets in the way of other things? Because I know that happens to me. And then you've got the sigil keeper, the keeper of secrets, the keeper of your book of shadows, your diaries, your magical stuff, your law of attraction stuff, the sigil keeper, symbols, signs and messages. Wow. Libra, I couldn't have made that up. That, look at that down there. That is amazing. You are just standing in such a powerful position. Don't be tempted to use that power to manifest for other people. They have to learn to do that for themselves. But what you can do is that high vibrational energy is send that energy out into the world and help the world heal, help the world feel better about itself. She needs it. She is waiting for us to do this work with her. You've got this down to pat, darlings. You really have. And if anybody comes on here and says, I'm not getting any of my manifestations, I'm going to be having words with you, because I'm saying to you, you are doing this. You are getting your manifestations. And if you're not, this is your resistance. That's what you need to look at. That's what you need to look at. And your justification. Keep a check on that because it can block you. Lovelies, wherever you are in the world, please be safe and I will catch you in the next reading. Bye for now.